residents of Riot City. My name is Carmine Liguzio, and once again, I am joined by the historian Angus R. Dacey for another exciting episode of RCW Blast.
Yeah, and what a couple weeks we've just had, Carmine. What a Riot City Rumble. We now know the main event for Battle for Supremacy will be Matt Hayter against Katie Trey.
Oh, this is a huge match. Absolutely enormous. And the rest of the card, it's all taking shape now too. And it's honestly, it has the potential to be one of the shows of the year.
Oh,
if
yeah.
Not the show of the year.
Yeah, Brighton Performing Arts Center, we saw that video that you published.
Yes. We went down there. You'll never believe who filmed it. We went down there, we filmed it, showing off the new venue. It's very, very exciting. But before we get there, we have an RCW blast for you. We know that you guys want to see more matches from Punk Rock Riot Round 2. And by golly, we got some.
We have some matches. Let's tell you what we have today on RCW Blast. We have a tag team match to kick things off. It's going to be Outback's Most Wanted against Grimm and Banjo Powers.
That's right. That is an interesting match, and I think that it's one that you're going to see a very interesting tag team dynamic with Grimm and Banjo Powers. Almost kind of a David versus Goliath sort of thing.
Yeah, right? Big man, little man tag team.
But together, yeah.
Hey, let's see how they go.
That's right.
Up next, we have an RCW Women's Championship match. Savannah Summers defending against Violet Blitz and Izzy Shaw.
And we had Izzy Shaw sort of hijack the show last week. Cut a little promo saying what she's going to do. She wants to win. If she could win, this would be the second time she would hold the RCW Women's Championship.
Yeah, and Violet Blitz looking to right the wrong of Riot City Rumble.
Yeah.
Defeat Savannah Summers. The title is on the line this time, so
let's
see how she goes.
Absolutely, and what is the final match of the show?
Well, our main event, a non-title tag team affair.
Yes.
It's going to be the Armstrongs reuniting once again to take on Brady LTD. And, of course, we saw Brady LTD defend against world-class egos at the Riot City Rumble.
We also saw them try to eliminate each other from the Rumble, too.
Not try. Dean did.
Well, did. Yeah. Well, yeah. The less said about that, the better. But don't worry. I think they're going to be on the same page in this match.
We'll find out. So a huge stacked edition of RCW Blast to look forward to. Why don't we see you in the first match right here, of course, on RCW Blast.
Right, Angus, we are here with Punk Rock Riot Round 2, the second sesh of this amazing event. This is an interesting matchup. We have the Hotshot Banjo Powers teaming with Matt Grimm Basso. He's feeling a lot better, and they are taking on the team of Outback's Most Wanted, who we recently saw face world-class egos in a losing effort, but they weren't wanting to get a win on the board here at an important time of the year.
Yeah, the clock is running down. The calendar is running out of pages, Carmine.
Yeah.
We're rapidly approaching the end of the calendar year, and you want to get as many wins on the board. And for Banjo Powers, we have seen a real change of heart in this young man. He put in that excellent, excellent performance at the Grey Street Massacre. And then again in the Rumble, he was desperate to eliminate Katie Trey, but he couldn't do it.
Yeah,
and Katie Trey eliminated him.
That's right. Now, look at the explosivity. You're just seeing speed and athleticism and just snappiness to Banjo Powers here. He actually mentioned recently that he had actually experienced that whole wave brain thing, you know, that the Brady LTD had talked about with me and you before.
Yes.
You talked about it too. I don't know, there's an energy there ever since that match, like we talked about, where it was him and Katie versus Brady LTD. Yeah, he's a changed man. Now we have, he made a tag, he's got Grimm in. It's Grimm and the deceptively large down under.
Deceptively large.
This guy's a big guy. He's intimidating. I've seen him backstage and he's a scary guy.
Now down under, he's got to be a bit steamed right now because he didn't do very well in the Riot City Rumble.
No.
He was, I think, the first or the second man eliminated. And look,
he's taking it out.
Taking his frustrations out on Grimm.
That's good.
We'll talk about Grimm and the Riot City Rumble in a second, but Grimm not taking that one lying down. Huge lariat there. Flattens down under.
Smart move, getting out.
And of course, Grimm, we saw he made his presence felt, not medically cleared to compete
at the
Riot City Rumble. But big springboard forearm there.
I love that. You were saying to me, Angus, that's been one of Grimm's new new things he's picked up since his return, right?
Yeah, it's been one of his moves he's added to his arsenal, you know, added to his repertoire.
You're a historian. You're also a move historian.
I know. I'm very aware of new moves that these guys add. Right there, new move right there. By
that's it. That's down fantastic under. New move by the innovator.
The innovator of offense down under. But Grimm fires back with a shot of his own. And as I mentioned, Grimm, not medically cleared to compete, entered the Riot City Rumble and eliminated Baron and Einar the Strange, getting some revenge on Purgatory.
Speaking of
revenge, Jesse Hendy there. And oh,
what was that? Hey.
A low blow from down under.
Michael Anderson, please turn around. Please, my man.
Now down under, firing some shots away at Grimm. Banjo powerless right now, unable to do anything.
Oh,
cover.
Like, that's good.
Just the two, says referee Michael Anderson.
Okay. Down under in control here. Clubbing to the back of the neck, the traps. We've talked about it before. It is absolutely debilitating to be sore in that area because it inhibits your ability to lift. It just completely saps your energy here. And we speak about innovation. A little slam there using old nephew Jesse Hendy.
Yeah, right? Only garnering a two count there.
Yeah.
Jesse Hendy. And we mentioned this before, Jesse Hendy, you know, he's not the sharpest tool in the shed, but he can take a beating like the one he just took. He just took two shots from Grimm to fire one back of his own. That's the kind of guy Jesse Hendy is.
That's
he's a brute, he's a brawler, and he's tagged his uncle the Down Under back in.
That's right. Angus and I will always be the Down Under truthers, right? We know him before he got famous.
Of course. And How would you rate Down Under's 2022 Carmine so far as we round the final curve towards the end of the year?
Well, we have to acknowledge that he was a singles title holder. Now, it may not have been in Riot City Wrestling, but of course we take into account all the history of pro wrestling in South Australia and Australia.
That's right.
So, you know,
defended it on the ACW Evolve
title
is what you're alluding to.
That's right.
Defended it at Tumby Bay, recently hooked up with Jesse Hendy.
Have a look at this, Angus.
Hold on. Combination offense there. Guillotine leg drop across the knee.
One of my favorite moves.
One, two, oh, and Grimm kicks out.
No, but, you know, continuing on, like, yeah, that he's genuinely, I think, had a really, really solid year. And it's interesting because he's had, you know, that sort of hero's reaction when he was in
Tumby
Bay. And to be honest, he kind of got a hero's reception at ACW too.
He definitely did. And right now, Banjo Powers wants that tag, and there's an opportunity, but wait! Oh no! I believe Down Under just yanked Jesse Hendy off the apron.
Talk
about a hero right there. There's your hero.
That's the thing. These are not good guys. They're not good guys.
Codebreaker from Hendy follows it up. Big boot to the side of the head.
Love that.
Could this be it? Jesse Hendy, the cover, hooks the leg.
Two.
No. Grimm rolls that shoulder up. His fingertips away from Banjo Powers.
The explosive Banjo Powers, he needs to come into this match. He's kind of fresh, really. He's only in there for a cup of coffee, as they say.
Exactly.
So, really neat. Oh, we're going for the scoop again. No, this time the knees up.
Yeah, Grimm
the
gets
knees
those,
are up.
Grimm gets those knees up on that slam attack there by Down Under and Jesse Hendy. Now Grimm, jawbreaker. Opportunity finds itself.
And tag.
The tag is made. Here comes the hot shot. Shotgun dropkick from the second rope. And the kip up from the hot shot Banjo Powers.
All right, stay on him, Banjo. Stay on him.
He is on fire right now. Head of steam. Banjo Powers charging into both corners. Down under, out of the way. But Banjo gets the boot up to the second rope again. Beautiful Hurricane Rana by Banjo. Ducks the line of Jesse Hendy now around and tilt-a-whirl DDT.
Absolutely picture perfect.
This could
DDT.
Be a Carmine. Two. Oh, Down Under saving his little buddy just in the nick of time.
Right on time. That's why this is a formidable team here.
I think 2023 is going to be a big year for Outback's Most Wanted.
Yeah, if they don't get caught.
Yeah, if they don't get caught, that's right. Right now, up and Banjo Powers escapes that one. Grimm comes in.
Clubbing.
Double lariat to both men, and now setting Jesse Hendy up.
Here we go. Oh, he got it 6 feet in the air just about.
Yeah, beautiful choke slam. Now, Down under. Spider boot from Grim.
That was fantastic. Here we go.
Grim laying Jesse Handy on top of his uncle. Banjo now still the legal man. Goes up top. What has he got in mind from here? Big splash from the top into the cover now. Grim assist 2-3. What a win for Grim and Banjo.
A fantastic, emphatic win from this new tag team. Very exciting to see.
Sign of respect there from Grim. Great showing from Banjo Powers right here, Carmine, on RCW Blast. Up next, the RCW Women's Championship is on the line as Savannah Summers defends against Izzy Shaw and Violet Blitz. We're back on RCW Blast with women's action now. The RCW Women's Championship on the line. Savannah Summers defending against Violet Blitz and Izzy Shaw. And wasn't Izzy Shaw impressive at the Riot City Rumble, Carmine?
You read my mind. That was the first thing I was going to say. She came in, she suplexed the guys like it was nothing. The absolute strength and power of Izzy Shaw was truly on display, but not the greatest start for her here, because we have Violet and Savannah. Oh, wait a minute. Double clotheslines.
Oh, taking a page out of Grimm's book right there.
I was gonna say, you know, she was.
Oh wait, hold on, Carmine.
What's going on?
There it is. There it is.
Oh,
the exploder suplex from Izzy Shaw.
Patented exploder, the Izzy suplex. I don't know if it has a name yet, but
she did not make us wait long. And right there, taking it to the women's champ, Izzy Shaw's second opportunity this year.
I'm loving the confidence
to get the title back. But Violet Blitz took it to Savannah in non-title action, came up short.
Yeah, this is a chance for redemption here.
Hey, she could become women's champion right here tonight.
That's right.
Izzy Shaw, of course, former women's champion. Savannah Summers, longest reigning women's champion.
Yep.
Very close to become longest reigning champion of any kind in RCW.
That's right, yeah.
Got across that 666-day barrier set by Rocky Monero.
Yeah, yeah. So how close are we?
We're about 650 days, Carmine.
Oh, okay. All right. So imagine if one of these two women here could take it from her right before that record-setting reign.
That would be something. But Savannah Summers, wily veteran, showing her years of experience right there against Violet Blitz. These two renewing their rivalry from that match that really didn't get started because Amber was out there the entire
time, just meddling. Yeah, yeah. That was the mystery of that will, I think, continue to unfold as more events take place. It's a very odd situation to say the least.
I've not got a good read on what's going on.
No, it's very hard to, as Savannah.
Flatliner by Savannah Summers, patented offense from the champion. Violet Blitz, she did put it in a gutsy performance. She's a little firecracker, is she? But right now, she's got to stand up to Savannah Summers, who uncharacteristically signaling for some top rope offense.
Oh, here we go. I'm liking what I'm seeing.
Something new out of Savannah Summers. Oh,
yeah, yep.
Clever Violet Blitz.
That was clever.
Yeah, using the referee. Sends Savannah off balance. Now Violet.
Now where's Izzy Shaw here? Where's Izzy Shaw?
Yeah, she's been out of action for some time.
She's been out.
This is a women's title match. You want to
be here. There she is. There she is.
Izzy Shaw now. Oh, hold on.
Wait a minute.
Gets position. What has she got here? Powerbomb!
Oh!
Superplex! Izzy Shaw takes out both women.
Incredible. Absolutely incredible.
This is the strength.
What is with the strength of Izzy Shaw lately?
This is the best Izzy Shaw we've ever seen.
Yeah.
She is on the cusp of something great, Carmine,
you know,
right now.
I know she's wearing gear inspired by Spyro the Dragon, but she is going Super Saiyan.
Absolutely. Look at this double team offense. Again, taking out both challengers.
Double team as a single person.
Super kick from Izzy Shaw. Wow. Wow, she is operating on another level. Into the cover. Two. Whoa.
Oh, right on time there. I think we're about to have a new champ.
Yeah, desperation from Savannah.
Sheesh.
She saw her title reign ending right in front of her eyes. Izzy Shaw, big forearm. Codebreaker from Savannah Summers. Goes into the cover.
Is that
now.
It?
Lateral press, hooks the leg, and Violet Blitz breaking it up this time.
Very smart to break that up.
Now Violet Blitz in control. She's got something in mind, perhaps suplex.
What have we got here?
No, Savannah Summers gets her up on her shoulders. The Summers Stunner, taking out Violet Blitz. Savannah now to continue her reign. 2, 3.
That's it. That's all she wrote.
That's how you do it, folks. Savannah Summers still Riot City Wrestling Women's Champion. Great performance there by Savannah Summers right here on RCW Blast. Main event time now as Brady LTD take on the Armstrongs on RCW Blast. All right, Brady LTD non-title match against the Armstrongs right now. It's a main event here on RCW Blast, and we're going to get ring introductions right now from Andy Anderson. How did Jimmy C swing this? What? Okay, it's a tag team title match now, Carmine.
Okay.
The Armstrongs, well, I guess.
Look, let's be honest here. An Armstrong, that's, you know, another title reign for them, is potentially 3 seconds away. That's kind of exciting.
Well, okay, here we go. This is exciting. Another championship match right here on RCW Blast, Carmine.
Oh, hey, look.
We're bringing this to you exclusive here on the YouTube channel, Armstrong.
Genuinely against... had no idea this was going to happen, but as the fans in attendance, lucky of having known this, there are some huge stakes on the line now.
Well, this is the Armstrongs' first opportunity at the tag titles since Super Clash 2 back in 2019.
Indeed.
That match was against the Perea in that no DQ affair. And speaking of Perea, yeah, they'll be returning Saturday, December 17th, at Battle for Supremacy, Carmine.
Well, they were able to hack the feed and come in live via satellite.
Via satellite, indeed.
That's right. All right, so right now we have Jet, we have Dean.
We have Jet Armstrong going up against one half of the tag team champions and one half of PWI's 58th ranked tag team in the world.
That's right. I think you know, maybe 57 too low, but still a very good number regardless.
These guys, these two,
Dean and Delta Brady, they could go with any top tag team in the world right now. And at one point, the Armstrongs were that too.
Yes.
It has been a while since they tagged. You know, we all know this, but they still... When you see them, you realize that they still have it.
It's been a while since they were that fiery MCW tag team champion.
Yes,
team. Yes,
that's right. And we have the C4 Absolute Grand Prix finals, which will have Jet Armstrong taking on James Cray. So Nick not making it to the finals.
That's right, Nick losing to James Cray at the Riot City Rumble. Hold on, roll up now. No count. Dean Brady converting it. Hold on, we've seen him use this before.
Yes.
The Billy Goat's curse. That's that elevated reverse Boston Crab, Carmine. And we saw him use this against Matt Hayter at the Riot City Rumble.
That's right.
Now it's Jet Armstrong's turn to meet the bottom turnbuckle pad. Just humiliating.
Absolute concussion warning right there.
Humiliating the Emerald Crown holder. Dean Brady celebrating.
Okay, that's my favorite celebration taunt.
Dean Brady.
Put the hands, clasp them together, and celebrate like your embryo and crash bash.
And here comes Delta. This is Dean and Delta's signature tag team offense. Delta will drop the elbow right on the back of Jet Armstrong.
And did you see Nick try and get her?
Yeah, Nick trying to intervene there.
Yeah.
Not successful on that occasion.
Yeah.
How do you think Jet is feeling knowing that he's got a big time matchup against James Cray on the horizon?
Well,
do you think his full attention's on this tag title match?
Look, probably not, but a champion, or at least a champion that, you know, we expect him to be, should be always looking to your next defense, but also should be looking right in front of you too. You don't want to get distracted. You have to have multiple focuses at the end of the day.
Of course. And I think that is the champ's downfall in 2022. Yep. That obsession with being...
Oi! Did you see that?
Big shoulder block there by Delta.
But you're so right. You're so right. As Delta takes it to Nick.
Oh!
Throwing him around.
Huge Beal halfway across the ring goes Delta into the cover. Lateral press hooks the leg and Nick kicks out. Yep. But to my point, Nick Armstrong has been obsessed with becoming that Grand Slam champion in 2022. It's like he's had tunnel vision. Nothing has been able to shake him.
And we're seeing what can happen when that may not go exactly to plan. Yeah, that Nick, was dirty.
Oh, big lariat. Nick, only one win out of those three matches in the C4 Absolute Grand Prix.
Yeah.
He fell to both Jet and... Oh, sorry, Party Guy and... Yep. And Nick, James Cray, of course.
That's right, yeah. Well, you know what? He did lose to himself in some ways, you know?
He did lose to himself,
Yeah. He lost the mental game, I think. I mean, look, I don't want to be just trashing him here, but yeah, I think that's why.
And what
look, if he could end the year here with winning the tag team titles, I mean, that would almost, it wouldn't make it all worth it, but damn, it would be pretty impressive.
Oh, and that was so close right there. The Armstrongs very close to becoming new champions.
They are. That's the thing. It's as I said, it's 3 seconds away.
And what can we say for Jimmy C this year?
What can we say about Jimmy C? Well,
he started the year off managing Jet Shaw.
Yeah.
And now he's managing, I guess, a champion in Jet Armstrong.
I think it's safe to say that man has made many enemies. He involves people's families when he speaks to the crowd or when he's on commentary. He really, there's no line that he won't cross. And deep down, we kind of knew this. You know, we've talked about it before. We talked about it in RCW
Jimmy
Blast.
C.
Yeah,
it's the former general manager just coming. It's been inside Jimmy C this whole time.
Yeah, it has.
And look at this right now, using Delta's hair as a weapon. That's an illegal tactic, Jet. But of course, knowing you now, there's no line you won't cross. They call Jimmy C a sycophant, calls him the king.
That is a horrible visual there.
Not very regal, if you ask me.
No. Not very gentlemanly.
And just flipping off Dean Brady right there as well. Jet Armstrong now.
Hey,
drops the elbow right on the lower back of Delta.
You have to say it with this environment, this rowdy crowd. I do feel like even though he is reprehensible, Jet really does thrive in this environment, doesn't he?
Oh, Jet has. You cannot argue that Jet hasn't thrived this year.
Yeah, that's the thing. You were talking about Nick, Tale of Two Armstrongs, as Jet makes the tag here to Nick. That, yeah, really, it's like Jet has had a year that is just, you know, from an in-ring standpoint and from, you know, in terms of winning, he's gone from strength to strength.
There he is, Jet. Concerned, perhaps, that he might not win the tag titles, and Dean as well.
Exceptional work there, getting Dean's desperation.
Desperation by Dean Brady. Yeah, Jet Armstrong has had probably the best year of his career, the most successful year.
No, I wouldn't say probably. I would emphatically say it, Angus. I would emphatically say it.
That's fair enough, and you know, it's rare to see at such a late stage of a career, such a banner.
That's
year.
Right. Not since his Golden Aztec days.
That's
yeah.
right. That's
yeah,
right.
Yeah, yeah.
Are we confirming the existence of Jet as the Golden Aztec?
Yes. You know what?
Well, Delta, she's firing out of this predicament. Tries to get the tag. Fingertips
he's got
away.
It. She's got it. She's got it.
No. The tag was never made.
Oh, that looked like that, honestly.
Roll up now.
We're going to have to get the video ref back for this one, I reckon.
And
both
going down. Both thinking lariat, both connecting. Now, who's going to get to their partner first? Dean is desperate to get Delta into this one.
And the crowd are into this too. Here we go.
Tag made. Here comes Dean, flattening Jet, flattening Nick. One more for Jet, one more for Nick.
This is incredible.
Goes to the midsection of Jet. Here we go, suplex coming up.
No. Oh,
the champ.
Oh. Is he going for double?
Hold it, Armstrong's trying to get Dean up. Dean too strong. Dean!
Oh!
Double suplex! Incredible right there!
The strength of this man.
Shades of the blue chip athlete we know from the past coming back. And now gets Jet in a precarious position. Just putting one out. Big sit out power bomb.
And I think that's it, Angus. That is it.
Vitamin D, Brady.
One,
here we go.
Two.
Wait a sec.
And of course.
Nick. Just yanking the referee out.
Unsurprised. Oh, what's going on here? Hey, that's enough. Nick Armstrong. You do not do that. A referee is completely off limits from being able to be. They are not a competitor.
That's right.
They are not a competitor.
And now Nick just distracting.
This should be it.
Oh, no! Oh,
you've got to be kidding me.
The dirty tactics of the Armstrongs.
I've just about, you know what? We were excited to have them teaming again. I am not excited about this. This is ridiculous. They are going to cheat to get a victory here.
And we could see new tag team champions
maybe
here.
There's that Emerald Crown.
Jet lines up Dean. Oh! Dean
karmic
out of the
revenge.
Way.
Karmic revenge, Angus.
Dean, Dean gets out of the way, makes the tag. No referee to see it. And now Jet is in the firing line of Delta. Up on the shoulders, Fireman carry position. The F5 connects. And now Jet is in between a rock and a hard place as Brady LTD rally the troops behind them.
Alrighty, here we go.
Jet gets to his feet. Here it comes, the wave rain. The high and low, the wave rain, whatever you want to call it. Here we go, 2, 3, Brady's retained.
That was close, Angus. That was extremely close. We were that close to getting new tag team champions. But of course, Brady LTD victorious here at Punk Rock Riot Round 2 on RCW Blast.
And that was Punk Rock Riot Round 2. What a fantastic little show there.
Yeah, look, I can't wait to be back at the Adelaide Unibar. Oh, what a venue.
Yeah, me too, Angus. I mean, just such incredible vibes. And I know that vibes are sort of an individual feeling, but like just being there, soaking it in, with the live bands like we talked about before too, being there to kind of contrast the action. It was just a really fantastic event. Could not speak more highly about it. And when we do one again, we'd love to see you there.
Absolutely. But for right now, for Carmine Liguzio, I've been Angus Ardesi. Thanks for watching RCW Blast. Farewell for now, but not